you find it?
There she is.
15.
1.
In 10. 5. 4.
Now, after two victories by Alex Seymour, Dave Davis defeated him in the third head-to-head game, and we go into the finals of the Cougar Open. Mike McGrath, Dave Davis, $10,000 to the winner of this game, $6,000 for second.
And Chris, it is a rematch of the 40th and final game last night. Davis was the leader. McGrath beat him to be the tournament leader. So this is a replay.
And McGrath starts with a strike.
And you're going to see a different Mike McGrath. He was the tournament leader last year in the Cougar Open, his first time on network television, and he had a miserable afternoon. He's shown great experience gained since that time, the last 2 weeks on television. This is his third week in a row, and he's gained valuable experience, Chris.
That's right. Came in second last week. Davis. And like that, we have an even match. Through one.
Pretty cool performer here, Chris.
You know, I can think of two people watching this telecast, Billy, who like that type of bowling. Our old friend Junie McMahon up in Paterson, New Jersey, and right here in Miami, the man that got me started in bowling telecasts, Peter DeMet.
Right, and it was a pleasure renewing acquaintances last week in Madison Square Garden with Helen and Junie McMahon, one of the all-time greats, and like Don Carter, in the Hall of Fame.
Right. Ooh. 6-10 for Dave Davis. Dave Davis. Bowler of the Year in 67 and 68. Won the Firestone Tournament of Champions, a two-time winner of the PBA National Championship. 12 titles to his credit. Strike and a spare for Davis, and up steps Mike McGrath. Strike up, shooting in the second. Actually, what they're bowling for is 16 grand and two automobiles. Not bad. Didn't quite come up.
Right, Chris.
Leaving the 3-5-6.
Got that ball a little out there with his arm and not so much with his fingers. He didn't have as true a swing that time. Therefore, it didn't get that revolution from left to right back into the 1-2 pocket. It's been very steady, Chris. This young man has cashed 21 consecutive tournaments now. He's really got his game in top shape. But this is like a separate tournament when you're bowling a one-game match, do or die.
Oh, old fancy footwork, delighted with what happened. That's his second strike in three frames. Now Davis, to keep it even, must strike. Can he make it level? Six, 10.
Got a great break too there, Chris, knocking eight out. He was a little slow. That's the slowest shot that he has made thus far this afternoon. And you can't afford that today, Chris. The ball is breaking so sharp in those last 5 or 6 feet.
So two pins now separate these two champions. Shooting in the fourth frame carefully. Wiping the ball now, drying the left hand.
It's a pretty deliberate performer, Chris. There you see him taking a good bit of time.
One time.
leaving the 5-6 on the left lane.
Chrissy tried to go to more speed that time, and he got a little bit of loft in there and caused the ball to slide for him.
Mm-hmm.
Not a difficult spare. He's got to try to split the 5 and the 6 with the ball touching ball. No, he's got to come way.
Ooh, chopping the 5 off the 6, and it's an open for Davis in this championship final match. Now he trails by 15. We'll be back with more of the final match between Dave Davis and Mike McGrath here at the Coliseum Lanes in just a moment.
Barber College, final shaving exam. What, an electric razor? Oh, and Williams Electric Shave, I see. Now you'll give a shave that feels barber close. Electric Shave makes whiskers stand up for a closer shave. Lubricate skin for a non-irritating shave that feels barber close. Here's the instructor.
That's barber close. Barber close, Henry? Feels barber close, all right. You did it with that?
Look for the big L. First letter in...
Electric Shave!
Please, Daddy, you promise not to smoke anymore.
Sound familiar? Here's the help you may need. Try Nicoban lozenges or new medicated gum. Every day, Nicoban is helping thousands break the cigarette habit. Let Nicoban help you cut down or stop smoking, often without gaining weight. Doctors have been recommending Nicoban for years. Is somebody you love asking you to break the cigarette habit? Why wait? Try Nicoban. Nicoban sure beats smoking.
Behind Rhea Blondie and Bernie Brown of the Lincoln-Mercury division is Sandy McGrath, whose husband now steps to the line. The possibility to double and increase his lead. Couldn't do it. 3-5-6. Tournament leader, as he was a year ago at the Cougar Open in Paramus at Frank Esposito's lanes. And this is what he had to say about shooting that 149 a year ago.
The Cougar Open has very fond memories for me and a little bit of disappointment. I was the leader last year in the same position that I am this year, and I pulled a 149. Of course, 1 year's experience and better mental attitude, and my physical game is much better than it was last year, partly due to my wife's help and her understanding of my mental outlook. And I just hope I can do a lot better this year and maybe come out and win this tournament.
Well, now both bowlers have open frames. Leaving the 7 on the left lane, Mike McGrath, a graduate of Chico State.
He was a marketing major, I think, Chris.
Yes. Met Sandy at a bowling center where she worked the night desk.
On that spare, he got a little too much speed and went sailing down the lane. The ball did not grip for the hook, and he left the six pin.
Well, instead of a 15-pin lead, Davis now only trails by 3. He had an open in the 4th, as you remember. He's now stroking in the 5th. Stuck at the line, but he still came through with a booming strike.
Slightly, Chris, but he, feeling it, went with a long follow-through, really extended it behind that foul line.
Six-pin, Davis.
Chrissy really wanted that strike. Naturally, that was for the go-ahead and really the take-charge ball and to put the pressure on McGrath. Sure, from what Mike McGrath had to say over his audio tape, you heard it. There's undue or excessive pressure already on McGrath. Memories of last year will cause that to happen.